Delta COVID-19 cases in the Western Visayas region have risen to 52. 21 of those were detected in the province of Kalibo. For more background on these patients and how they were contact traced, we have with us Aklan Governor Florencio Miraflores. Good morning, po, Governor. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Nikki. Good morning, Mike.
Okay, so first off, we understand, po, na you have 21 Delta cases. Are they local cases and how are they being treated right now? Has contact tracing also been done?
Yes, we were given this report by the Genome Center that out of the 58 samples that we submitted, this was actually last July 28, you know, only that the results were given to us 2 days ago, August 22. So in July 28, 58 samples were given. And 21 of these turned out Delta variants. So that's around 36% positivity rate for the Delta variant here in the province of Aklan. So right now we are doing backtracing. Actually, out of the 21 Delta variant cases, 20 has recovered already. Only one died. Of course, we regret that. But we are now conducting backtracing for all of those 20 identified cases. And we are now, as mandated, we do the quarantine. We also did the quarantine now of these cases. And we do repeat testing so that we will know if they still have these variant cases in their bodies.
And Governor, how is the situation on the ground? How are your hospitals doing in terms of bed capacity and manpower?
Well, we actually had a surge starting July. We had a surge of almost 2,000 cases, active cases at that time from July to first week of August. And so we asked the national government, IATF, to place the province in a new category of MECQ. And we had stricter border controls. We also had stricter curfew hours starting at 8. We closed our offices at 4, businesses at 5, so that we can contain this further spread of the variant. And we are quite successful because from August 1 to 22, as of today, August 25, we have reduced our active cases by almost one half. So we are slowing down the surge. And the main reason for that is that we implemented more stricter controls. We instituted again the use of our quarantine passes. We're not allowing people to go out of their households. Only one can go out while looking for essential services. And we also instituted travel passes to control the movement of people. And we are now slowing down the surge. And also, during the surge in July and first week of August, our healthcare utilization rate was almost 81%. Our hospital was almost full. Our ICU beds were full. Our COVID wards were full. But since that time, when we instituted these stricter measures and slowed down the surge, we are now back to low risk, meaning our healthcare utilization is back to 38%, less than 40%.
That's so good to know.
Yes, so we also, because when the surge happened in July, we already attributed this to the Delta variant, because the first Delta variant was reported in Antique, that was last May, and we are a border province of Antique. So we assumed that the surge was really the Delta variant. That is why the July 28th results was just a confirmation. And that's why we instituted immediately these measures so that we can stop the surge. And we are now actually slowing down the surge.
Right. And Governor, going back to your hospital situation, what about oxygen tanks and other medical supplies? Do you have sufficient resources to meet the demands of the surge?
Yes, we have enough oxygen supplies, we have enough medical supplies, we have all the medicines ready. But what happened during the surge is that we lacked already the healthcare workers. So we actually asked the help of the Department of Health Regional Office to give us or to send more health workers, because at that time our health workers were really stretched to the limit. There was a danger of actually a collapse of our medical system, because while we have the number of beds available, we have the supplies and medicines and oxygen, wala na kaming mga nurses. Our nurses were already overworked, our doctors were overworked. And so the DOH sent some medical workers to us to help us cope with the situation. Mm-hmm. And well, as of now, with additional health workers, we are now in a low risk category in terms mm-hmm. of healthcare utilization.
And the governor, yung vaccination efforts po, how are they going?
Kulang pa rin, no? Actually, out of our targeted population of 298,000 to reach herd immunity of 70% of our people here in Aklan, only 60% has been vaccinated as of today. But the good thing is that the DOH is now ramping up their vaccines. Actually, as we speak, we'll be receiving more than 45,000 doses of Sinovac, Moderna, and Pfizer. And so with this ramping up of our vaccines, we hope to really stop the surge already.
And the governor, another aspect, you have two business groups on Boracay Island seeking a quarantine designation separate from Aklan province, concerned about the island's tourism sector. Also saying that it's physically separated naman kasi from the rest of the province, and that controlling the movement of people can be efficiently managed. How will you be addressing this?
Well, they have brought this to my attention already, Aniki, but as of this time, with the surge that happened, at this point in time, we cannot yet give them a separate quarantine classification, because the workers are coming from mainland Aklan. All of the businesses are also relying on the province of Aklan, mainland Aklan, mm-hmm. and we cannot really separate them at this point in time. Maybe in the future, once the situation improves, then we can also make some adjustments to our restrictions in Boracay, considering that this is our main driver of growth in our economy. And we're really hoping to open up also Boracay. As of now, Miniki, we cannot also open up if we want it, because Manila NCR is still in this queue. And you're not even allowed to go out of Manila to visit the tourist destinations. So we're just hoping that once MECQ is lifted from Metro Manila, then we can also open up Boracay for tourists.
All right. On that note, we're just hoping for the best. Thank you so much for joining us, Governor Miraflores. You stay safe.
Thank you very much, Nikki, for this opportunity. Thank you very much.